Hi, I'm Tim Callahan, Chair of Geology and Environmental Geosciences, and I'm also a professor specializing in hydrology. And I want to talk about some of the small group and one-on-one opportunities that students have with our professors. We have a lot of what generally is referred to, and you may have heard this term, experiential learning opportunities. And that includes doing projects around the area, out at Stone Oak Preserve, our campus down in the Hollywood, Ravenel area. And then we also have study away opportunities, some of which are run through the study abroad program. We have one to Northern India. We have one to South Africa that happen typically in the summer. And then we also have study away trips domestically out west to Wyoming, to New Mexico, and Colorado. And you don't necessarily have to take a big trip to another state or another country. We have lots of opportunities in a virtual platform to get those sorts of experiential learning opportunities. And if you're interested in getting hands-on for specific applications in the geosciences, we have the BEAMS program, which is a marine geology program with a subset of courses where you get to learn about managing data for hydrography, which is the field that involves mapping the seafloor. And there's a lot of applications in the energy business, both traditional and alternative energy. We have opportunities for students to get on a research vessel and learn how to run that technology and take the data and interpret those data. And similarly, we have a new geoinformatics minor. That's a collaboration with computer science. And in that minor program, some of which involves using technology like drones to collect your own data, take that data and make maps and put that into a GIS software framework and interpret that information for lots of different purposes. And all of these opportunities fit into our sustainability literacy program, where social, economic, and environmental issues are at the forefront.
To bring you this important message.
Hello, I'm Dr. Scott Persons. I'm a professor here at the College of Charleston, and I'm curator of the Mace Brown Museum of Natural History. The Mace Brown Museum of Natural History holds thousands of very cool fossil specimens from all over the world. And as a student in geology, you'll have the opportunity to interact and get to know many of them. Let me show you a few.
This massive set of chompers belongs to the enormous shark Megalodon. And you can find the teeth of Megalodon scattered across the beaches here in Charleston, a remnant of the sea beasts that once were. Behind me now is our exhibit on the primordial seas, which shows you sea life originating over 2 billion years ago and moving all the way up to critters that are only recently deceased. Students here at the College of Charleston, if you come into our geology program and have an interest in paleontology, can do research on all these different critters. In fact, some of the animals behind me, including this sea turtle here, have been the subject of student research projects. We also run a regular field camp out in the Badlands of Wyoming. And we've got programs here that work on some of the local fossils as well. The animals you see closest to me are all native Charleston beasts. Let me end by showing you the newest addition to the museum. This is a specimen that I've done work on. You're looking at casts of the skull of the Tyrannosaurus rex known as Scotty. Scotty is in fact the largest T-Rex specimen that's ever been found.
Oh, I didn't see you there. I'm Dr. Robert Bosenecker. I'm a paleontologist here in the department. This is the Mace Brown Museum Natural History Preparation Lab. This is where we clean fossils. Most fossils, when they come out of the ground, look pretty gross. We have a number of different methods we can use. Most basically using little hand tools, I teach students as well how to use more involved machinery like air scribes, which are powered by an air compressor. We also do a fair amount of acid preparation where we will take rocks like this and dissolve away the limestone using acetic acid. Many students have gone through here. Some have done it for credit, others have volunteered, but we've had at least a dozen students or so over the past few years leave this laboratory with a fair amount of experience cleaning, repairing, and curating fossils under their belt.
Hey everyone, we're the Geology Club. I'm Cole Buddy, and I'm the president.
Hi, I'm Jordan James, and I'm the treasurer.
I'm Olivia Gonzalez, and I'm the secretary.
And we're here to tell you about who we are and what we do. We love to host informational brown bag meetings about environmental sciences, and we have a lot of fun activities planned this semester.
Some of our fun activities include rock painting, beaches, paddle boarding, and we're going to try to do rock climbing this semester.
We're really excited to meet everyone.
All right, awesome. My name's Sam Croft. I'm the previous Geology Club president, and I'm a recent graduate of 2020.
Yeah, I'm Michaela Drost. I was the president of Sigma Gamma Epsilon, and like Sam said, we were 2020 graduates of the Department of Geology and Environmental Geosciences.
Oh yeah, and we're here, we've currently worked for a company called 3D at Depth that does subsea LIDAR.
Yeah, and I mean, we both got hired with the help of the geology department. Our boss is a former CFC alum. She was in the same research program we were in, the BEAMS program, which focuses on hydrographic surveys. And so it was really awesome to be able to be a part of that research group and then find a job where we were actually using what we learned in our majors.
Yeah, so probably the highlight of my time in the geology department was on field studies, which is mandatory for all majors who are getting like a BS in the department. And so you go out west, you get to explore all the national parks and learn how to actually do survey techniques in the field. And it's just a really great bonding experience with all of your classmates. Anybody?
Just keep losing. I'm losing.
I'm alright.
He's alright. He's alright. myself. One day I'm gonna be free. Find me somebody to love. 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 Find me somebody to love.
Working with undergraduates to provide them an opportunity to explore and learn how to use something known as geographic information systems. We prefer to call it GIS. It's a really cool software that allows for spatial analysis of any type of data that you have that had a spatial component. It provides opportunities to do research in all disciplines.
We're glad to welcome you here. Today we're going to be looking at this GIS information, which is where we take information from drones, satellites, LiDAR data, multiple data sources. We take maps and databases and mix them together to make new informations and new understandings of the world around us.
So you take a geology class, you take an environmental geology class, and you're really excited. And you go home and you tell your parents, "Hey parents, I think I'm gonna be a geology major." And they get this really funny look on their face. And they're like, "What? What are you gonna do with that?" Our graduates work for the CIA, the Department of Defense, and hurricane hazards and earthquake hazards. We have people in South Carolina Emergency Management. We have people in FEMA. We have people who are studying volcanoes. Oh, it'd be really sad that you have to go study a volcano. Okay, not because that's everybody's dream, is to play on a volcano. Researchers, we have a ton of students who are in the oil, gas, geothermal fields. We have students spread in every field across disciplines, because geology is a renaissance science. You can do everything with geology. So we have students across spectrums, and basically you get to experience in our department all sorts of skills, and then you can use those skills in almost any field, in any business, wherever you decide to end up. If you want to go to the UN, or if you want to go to Big Oil, geology will get you employed.
So all in all, the geology department is pretty nice.
Don't take this department for granted. Snap!
Oh, man.
so